It's a surprise.
The watercolour kind.
A field of vibrant lavender in Van Gogh's Provence. That's today's watercolour challenge. Hello, and welcome to Saint-Remy de Provence, and to the third of our special club members watercolour challenge. Well, it was in Saint-Remy that Vincent van Gogh spent his last years. This is how he described Provence. Here, nature is most amazingly beautiful. Everything is spectacular. The dome of the sky is a remarkable blue. The rays of the sun are pale sulphur. Well, I don't suppose our contestants today will disagree with that. Let's hope it inspires them. Come and meet them. Jewellery maker B. Morrison enjoys gardening and painting. She recently painted a mural of the lavender fields of Provence for a friend. Having never visited the region before, she found that quite a challenge. She's hoping today will be much more pleasurable. Paul Hoare is a graphic designer by trade and a DIY enthusiast in his spare time. At his watercolour class, no one will sit close to him because he's a very messy painter who flicks his paint around, so B had better beware. When Margaret White was a working doctor, she specialised in children's ailments and pioneered treatments for bedwetting. I wonder if she's any suggestions for curing Paul's wet habits. Their view today is a lavender field, backed by a cherry orchard.
Well, good morning to you all.
Good morning.
Good morning. Well, did you ever think that you would be painting lavender fields in France on Watercolour Challenge?
Yeah,
it's absolutely beautiful. Now, the owner of this farm says that his grandfather knew Van Gogh and that Van Gogh painted these orchards.
Oh, excellent.
So you're following in very illustrious footsteps. However, I asked myself, how long did it take Van Gogh? If it was more than 4 hours, he wouldn't have stood a chance on Watercolour Challenge. So don't be too put off in that case, and I'll see you later. Very best of luck. Yes. Bye.
Bye. When I arrived today, I think the main thing that surprised me was the light. It was the yellow light on the trees. And although there's lots of things that you could concentrate on here, my very favourite thing was the yellow. But I'm going to incorporate that, I think, with a little bit of the lavender in front. The lavender field is an interesting thing. It's got a very three-dimensional feel about it. And that would be absolutely ideal, I think, to get in the foreground to direct the viewer's eye, my eye, towards the main tree that's got the bike. I can see me having trouble with the bike.
When I first saw the view this morning with the lavender field, I thought trying to draw a whole field of lavender in one colour would be extremely difficult. But with all the sort of the well in the foreground and the bicycle at the back, it makes it a lot easier. I mean, I don't sketch too much, so it'd be a quick sketch and putting some paint on the paper.
Biggest challenge today is how detailed for me to do the close lavender. I'm not really an artist at all. I'm just somebody who likes messing around with watercolours, and all I can do actually is paint what I see. I'm going to paint the whole thing, keep it very wet, and have lots of gorgeous purple in the front. And then the nice well, and I don't want to detract from the well by doing too much detail. So this is my problem at the moment. Oh, how I wish to God I'd a bit more of Van Gogh's ability.
I've discovered our art expert, Jenny Wheatley, busy sketching in the cherry orchard. Now, Jenny, I was thinking today, it's so relatively simple and calm here. This could appear like a piece of cake, but I bet you're going to tell me it's not.
It's a very sophisticated problem. There are an awful lot of very simple areas, but really the challenge today is how to order them compositionally.
So it's composition.
Composition all the way through, and being very particular with the few solid objects that there are there.
Right. Still, wonderful place to paint.
It's absolutely fantastic. Frustrating, but fantastic.
Thanks, Jenny.
What I've got here are lots of sketches. This is how I normally work, with lots of reference. I've put them up here so that I can constantly refer to them. I'm going to put lots of water on it. And I also want to try and get the colours more or less in the right position, but it's going to be very, very wet. Most important colour is the yellow. So the little puddle there just gets transferred. The biggest problem is to bring all the sketches together into this picture. I'm still uncertain about the bike, but I've got a backup system. I've put a little loose patch of poppies there that will act as another focal point.
But it's wet, it really is wet and wet, dropping all these colours in before it dries. I do drop a lot of colours in. That's why I flick my brush a lot, just to get rid of some of the colours quickly. You've got to work quickly, that's the only trouble with it. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. What I'm really doing is just trying to get a general colour over the whole page. I want to get those colours in of the lavender just as loose as possible, so I don't have to worry about that again, a bit of luck. But there's all this green that's happening underneath the lavender. And that's really what I'm trying to quickly put in.
I'm not going to paint the sky as dark as it actually is, because it'll clash with the beautiful colour of the lavenders. I'm going to cheat here. I'm afraid I'm going to give it an English sky. If I give a Mediterranean turquoisey blue sky, it just won't be right.
Just across the road from the farm is the Saint Paul de Mozol Asylum, where Van Gogh came for help with his mental state in 1889. It's still a psychiatric hospital today, and it's a very tranquil place. The cloisters surrounding the tiny formal garden are among the most beautiful in France. During his time here, Van Gogh painted over 150 pictures, including some of his most famous works. At first, he stayed within the hospital grounds. But as he grew stronger, he ventured out into the surrounding countryside, where he found a wealth of inspiration in the cherry orchards, cypress trees, and olive groves around Saint-Rémy.
Starry, starry night, paint your palette blue and grey. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness in my soul. Shadows on the hills, sketch the trees and the daffodils, catch the breeze and the winter chills in colors on the snowy linen land. Now I understand what you tried to say to me.
Hi.
You enjoying it today?
Absolutely wonderful, yes. Yes. Thank you.
It's coming on very well, isn't it?
Yes, it's got all the main colours on now. Mm. And from here on, I've really got to layer more to darken them. And maybe bring a little bit more at the top. Mm. It's essentially there.
So it's going to keep sort of fairly wafty,
yes,
with a little bit more strength, yes, in there later on.
I just think it's lovely. It's as if you shut your eyes and said, what are the colours? What are the colours of Provence? And it's like a wonderful impression.
That's
of...
That's exactly what exactly. I did at the beginning.
Did you?
Yes.
Oh, that's
yes.
Nice.
Wonderful. I think when you start to put in some of your darker, mm-hmm, more specific shapes, maybe even that bicycle in there later on, or poppies, something, mm-hmm, more particular, I think you might find these are going to be a little bit pale. So I think it'd be a good idea to put something, mm, in there fairly,
yes,
soon.
Yes.
So that you know whether you've got this right or
you need to keep the next thing light, but you need to sort of get something to gauge it against soon, I think. Mm-hmm. So it'd be nice to see what happens in the second half.
Yes.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hello there, Paul.
Hello there.
Painting to the sound of crickets.
Yes, isn't it nice? Oh,
that's looking nice. What a lovely feel you've got already.
A few things resolved, yeah, but we'll see.
What are you thinking of resolving? Because it's a very complete start. It's lovely to see someone working all over a painting and building it up, you know.
It seems to be almost two paintings at the moment, so I've just got to... I think the shadows will tend to link it all together.
It's going to change a lot, because at the moment you're very aware of this, because it's the only dark to light piece, isn't it?
Indeed.
But you're going to need to make a note of these shadows, because they're going to move very rapidly. So I'd start to work them all over very soon, I think,
right,
so that, you know, continuity throughout. But it's going to be lovely to see what happens with it next, isn't it? It's going to change, I think, a lot. Mm. Super.
Thank you much.
Bye.
Studied person. It's hardly your archetypal English summer, this, is it, Margaret?
It certainly isn't.
I love the way you've moved the well. Poetic license here.
Well, at a problem, do I make the well the dominant, or do I make the lavender field the dominant?
I think until you've got something that links this with the rest of the painting, I don't think that that's a decision to make. I think at the moment you've got a sort of hole here. You've got colour here and colour here, both of which on their own look very positive. But I think when you put something in between, whatever you put there is going to change the effect of sky to tree, to grass. And I think once you've got something in there, even if it's just washed across and you're happy with the relationship, I think then you can change this. So I think this is the next bit, and then you'll be able to appreciate the rest of it. I think it would be a very, very nice painting.
Will B's fresh Provençal colours appear too pale when she adds her darks? Can Paul decide which time of day to capture his shadows? And will Margaret manage to link her grass and her trees together?
Van Gogh wrote these words to his brother Theo. In the Midi, the imagination is fired. The hand becomes more agile, the eye more lively, the brain clearer. Well, I hope our artists are feeling just as inspired. Stay with us. See how their paintings progress.